guys, we're going to talk about the Hadean EA 100 CSB. This is there's two versions. There's this darker orangish one, and there's another lighter natural wood-looking one. I don't think there's any difference besides just how they look aesthetically. But obviously this one is a CSB model. And this one I got for $150 on Rondo Music, link at the bottom. And this guitar I've had, it's probably the guitar I've had the longest out of all my guitars. This guitar I've had for a very long time, I think maybe about 6 years. And it is the best purchase I've ever made in terms of guitars, period. And I'm gonna go over why. Okay, so first of all, I love the Les Paul body shape. As you can see, mine's a little dinged up. I've used it a lot, and I'll tell you where from. I love nylon guitars. They just sound better to me. I studied classical guitar in college and university, and so, you know, my background is classical guitar, but at the same time, I like electric guitars a lot, you know, and I play a lot. This is for the person that plays a lot of electric guitar, but loves that nylon guitar sound. Okay, there's nothing like it, and it's really, really nice to the ear. So, you know, I'm going to start up here. We've got a natural-looking classical guitar headstock. You know, nothing different about that. The tuners are great. I haven't had to do anything with them for five, six years. Going down, the neck is pretty solid. It's a bit thicker than normal. I would compare it to a Les Paul, actually, but it's not bad. It doesn't feel bad at all. You get used to it pretty quick. It is thinner, though, thinner than a normal classical guitar. Okay, so you don't get that, you don't have such a wide neck that you have to really be that classical guitarist to get used to. This is an electric guitar with it's just a little bit meatier, okay? And as we move down, you know, it's got a nice little cutaway here. How many frets? 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 frets. I could reach maybe the 20th fret with ease. 21st starts getting in the way, and 22nd, you kind of really got to get in there, but it's not too bad. Everything else is very solid. I've never had any problems with it. Mine is scuffed up. It's dinged up. I've got some wear and tear in the back. The input jack I've had to tighten up a little bit, but it's really not that bad. It's as easy as unscrewing it, tightening it up, and then doing it. I've probably had maybe two issues with it in the past, but that's it, just tightening it up. Another really cool thing about this instrument is the electronics. Okay, it does come with an onboard tuner, a phase switch, volume, which I have all the way down right now, treble, middle, and bass, and I keep them 12 o'clock position. There's a notch right there, so you could feel that 12 o'clock position. With volume, there's no notch. It's just 0 to 100, but I mean, of course, you can go in between. And other than that, it is very solid. It sounds great for $150. This guitar is a steal. It weighs, on the website, it says it weighs 7 pounds. Sounds about right. It's not a heavy guitar. It's fairly comfortable. There's no bevels, or what do we call them? Scoops in them. Okay, so everything's pretty rigid, which it's not too much of an issue. We're gonna play through it a little bit, and I'll show you some of the electronics, and we'll take it from there. Thanks, guys. All right, guys. So here is an up close of the electronics of the Hadean. You have here your tuner. It's very clear. Very clear, very nice. Love it. I wish you could change it to 432 or something different than 440. I haven't figured out how to do that. I figured it was moving one of these knobs, but never happened. Okay. So there's your tuner. This light will stay red when you have low battery. Batteries usually last, I can't even tell because I have this plugged in so much from teaching. So I can't give you guys an estimate. It's pretty good. And like I said, sorry, I can't give you a rough estimation. It really depends what battery you use. One time I used a really cheap battery. It went out in maybe like 3 weeks of playing it, but I left it plugged in a couple times. So anywho, here's the phase switch. I guess it inverts the phase. I can't really tell the difference. The examples that you will hear will have the phase out. Okay, but to me, there's really not that big of a difference. And of course, here's your EQ, treble, middle, bass. I keep them flat for me playing. They respond very well. And there's nothing really that I have complaints on. And the volume is also very, very good. It's a true bypass when you have it all the way left. And then, you know, you crank it as high as you can. And the battery, it's actually pretty cool. I'm going to grab it with my other hand. It's kind of ridiculous, but you hold these two down. You hold these two down, pull it out. Battery's in here. So this is kind of a cheap battery, but it's lasted me decent time. Just click it in, and there it is. It stays in there really well. It's never fallen out for me. So hope you guys enjoy the playing. Thanks again for tuning in, guys. Again, this was an awesome guitar. For $150, you cannot beat it. Sometimes it's on the Rondo Music website, sometimes it's not. I understand that they run out of stock pretty fast. So if you ever see one on there, I would recommend you throw down that $150. It's definitely worth the investment. I will go ahead and put a link to the in the description where you can buy it. I have also seen them on Reverb. I'll put a link to Rondo Music, and I'll also put the specs in the description. I don't know them off the top of my exact head, but you'll see them there, sure enough. Have a nice one, guys. Thank you.